Hello again, guys. I'm back with another video, and as I said last upload, I'd be changing up the category, albeit I'm still doing countdown videos, but hey, at least I changed the subject, right? Anyways, today I'll be doing a top 5 of my personal favorite Adult Swim shows. Why top 5? Well, for two reasons. Number 1, I hate doing top 10s because they're time-consuming and difficult to edit in the long run. Number 2, I haven't even really watched enough shows on Adult Swim to make a top 10, but don't get me wrong, I have watched quite a few. Now, onto the rules. Rule number 1, not all shows this time exactly have to be cartoons. They can be any type of show Adult Swim has aired throughout its history. Rule number 2, even if a live action show can be included, still, each show has to be primarily shown, if not a complete Adult Swim original. This means no Family Guy and no King of the Hill. And now with the rules out of the way, we can finally get to the countdown. I hope you guys enjoy. Number 5. To kick off this list, we'll be starting off with the classic, Robot Chicken. I go way back with this show, and to be honest, I remember watching it as far back when I was about 5 whenever I used to secretly watch Adult Swim out of curiosity, and I now consider it both good and bad decision at the same time, which are good qualities about the show. The violent shock humor and random composure of each episode is a staple of comedy. In episode skits, popular cartoon characters and cameos from franchises are utilized and put in gory adult situations. The humor can get dark and gloomy at times, but it's also simultaneously funny. Episode structure commonly consists of random clips being played throughout the episode, sometimes with reoccurring jokes to progress the humor. The animation is very unique, opting to use figures and toys to animate them through stop motion. It's very entertaining and humorous, and I've watched it for a long time. I've quoted the show many times, and from its wit and memorability, I'm glad the show lasted as long as it did. It made its legacy live on in Adult Swim. Number 4. The Eric Andre Show. Now this is where the second rule comes into play when I said it didn't exactly have to be a cartoon. It's to show that Adult Swim has many experimental type shows with variety. The Eric Andre Show is the demented, random, nonsensical, and bizarre talk show creation of Eric Andre, a comedian and voice actor alongside his co-host, Hannibal Buress. The show was all insanity and imperfections of any creation put into one single show. And to put it plain and simple, this was intentionally made to be the worst talk show of all time. And it succeeds with all flying colors in the best ways possible. And the reason is because it's hilarious. As well as his comedic genius in regards to Eric Andre's comedy style and approach in creating a show. Both the interviews of the guests, ignorant to how uncomfortable and broken the environment may be, as well as the crazy and over-the-top street skits commonly associated with obnoxious and colorful costumes and personas that are hilarious.
My name was L. Ron Hoyabembe. Who do we want?
Xenu!
When do we want him?
10 trillion years!
I have found myself binge-watching clips and episodes numerous times considering how good it is. Eric Andre has stated in numerous interviews that his objective was to make guests so uncomfortable and disturbed they walk off set because of them being unprepared for what they're about to be involved due to them lacking research about what they're actually getting into. This leads to hilarious results and reactions from any unfortunate celebrity and its comedic genius. As for the host, both Eric and Hannibal do an excellent job in presenting their characters and personas in the interviews and skits, making the environment of the urban streets of New York a playground to experiment in for the populace inhabiting the area they may be doing a skit at, be it a park, a restaurant, or a political convention. There's so much to say and praise about the show, but I'll just have to cut it short and simply say that this show is one of the best experimental shows Adult Swim has ever had the luck of having on the air, and I'll be waiting for season 5 to come around soon. Number 3. The Boondocks. Me and literally everyone else who has seen it loves this show. It's practically a staple boy of the Adult Swim block. The Boondocks is a satirical show about the position of black culture in America through the use of different situations revolving around the main cast. The show stars the cast of different physical caricatures of black culture. Huey Freeman is often the voice of reason, representing the positive progression of blacks in a political and social standpoint. Riley and Robert Freeman representing both negatives, more specifically, Riley portraying young African Americans consumed by ignorant and stereotypical black culture and endeavoring in airhead acts for money, fame, and possessions, and Robert representing the older generations of blacks stuck in the past and struggling in relationships, often allowing themselves to be manipulated. There's also other side characters that interact with the plot, like Uncle Ruckus, who is basically an Uncle Tom discriminating against his own race, and Tom Dubois, who is a neighbor of the Freeman residence that has been whitewashed and steered into being a complete goody-two-shoes. There's even more characters besides them. Stinkmeaner, Gangstalicious, Thugnificent, the Lethal Interjection Crew, Egg Wunsler, Gin Rummy, and so on. These characters serve as excellent comedic sources in terms of interacting with one another, and the personalities of each character lead for intelligent and well-delivered comedy in terms of political and social satire. Not to mention, their show also has the soundtrack score of, well, none other than Mad Villain. Fucking Mad Villain. So yeah, I don't really think I need to elaborate much more on how intelligent and humorous this show is. You see it being quoted left and right, everyone thinks numerous characters and episodes are hilarious, and it's become one of the most loved animated shows of all time.
Except season 4.
Number 2. The Oblongs. This show I actually began to watch recently over the summer for a while after being reminded of it. I actually heard of the show years ago because of a top 10 Looney Tunes made, but I actually never cared to watch it. Now that I have, I can say I made an excellent decision in doing so. Now, yes, I kinda may be cheating here, considering the show was originally premiered on the WB and Teletoon Unleashed, but I did say primarily or originally from Adult Swim, therefore this show can be on the list, but can you really blame me? This show is very underrated and it does deserve way more attention than it actually has gotten. I believe the reason though was due to a lack of involvement from the original creator, Angus Oblong. Yes, that is his last name, and the fact that its humor is also very dark on a legitimate level due to the fact that our main characters all have horrifying disabilities and deformities and live in a toxic wasteland due to economic inequality and discrimination amongst the bratty, asshole-y rich people. This show commentates on social problems in the world in an over-exaggerated way considering the circumstances of the characters in the show. However, the show is somewhat legitimate and true in on many socioeconomic issues in modern society. And the show came out in 2001, so you know it was ahead of its time for sure. Originally, however, the primary plot of the show was intended to revolve around Milo Oblong and his, unique friends screwing around rather than the Oblong family. In the words of Angus Oblong himself, he said, "It was a good show, but it wasn't his show." Regardless, the show is still a good hidden gem, and I suggest all of you watch it. It can be funny and also very intelligent in terms of humor and satire, and I assure you it's underrated personified. Finally, number 1. Aqua Teen Hunger Force. Point blank period, this was and always will be my favorite Adult Swim show. There are some people that like Squidbillies and Sea Lab 2021, but I initially watched this and I instantly fell in love with it. Aqua Teen Hunger Force is actually a spin-off of Space Ghost Coast to Coast, and it originally starred the main trio of the show, and they were intended to be an addition, but the idea was actually dropped, leading to Dave Willis and Matt Mylera creating Aqua Teen Hunger Force. To summarize the show, without going into a speech, it's random, vulgar, nonsensical, and funny as all hell. The show stars Master Shake, Meatwad, and Frylock, all miscellaneous food characters in a personified form that initially were detectives, but the idea was dropped considering the lower ratings. Eventually, by the fifth episode of season 1, the three partook in random situations that no one could usually think of. The plot ideas are bizarre, and it honestly is one of those shows where you need to simply turn your brain off to enjoy, and just laugh at the jokes and vulgar humor. To analyze each character simplistically, Master Shake is the narcissistic sociopath that usually tortures Meatwad and constantly comes off as with an over-the-top stupid ideas to improve his fame and money, or his poor self-esteem. Meatwad is the naive kid-like figure of the group that is usually subject to Shake's predicaments, and Frylock is the voice of reason that has to put up with their shit and usually has to save both of the other two. There's also Carl, not even gonna bother to say his last name, who is a neighbor of the two and usually has to put up with their schemes and mishaps and hates the three bothering them continuously. He also takes football way too seriously,
and he is a pornography addict.
Okay, moving on. In general though, the show is hilarious, and it makes no sense, but I always found a way to make me laugh, and it's definitely an Adult Swim hit. It lasted from 2001 to 2015, making it the longest running show in Adult Swim history, and it has cemented himself as the golden boy of Adult Swim. And I could never be gladder to find and enjoy for so long. Alright guys, I hope you enjoyed this short top 5 of my favorite Adult Swim shows. If you're still wondering why I still haven't made an official video on my main channel, again, I'm still looking for good games to play and time to do it, so just give me some time. And I'm sorry for the delay, next time I'll just try not to call an upload that I actually won't be able to do in the future, but like I said in the description of my newest video, I'll be making a Discord server on my main channel and it'll be available for you all, and I'll be sure to promote it on my social media outlets and let you all know. And it'll serve the same purpose as the other server, except just for the main channel, it'll be all good and everything, so, you know. And I believe that's all the announcements I have to make, and yeah. So again, I hope you all enjoyed the video. Give me some criticisms and feedback in the comment section, and leave a like or dislike. Subscribe for more content, and as always, this has been GameCube Boy 2002, and I'll see you next upload. Till next time.